try to think of AI much more in terms of how it helps us in an enterprise work with us and work with other computing systems. So we think of it more in terms of any computer system that can sense, think, and act along with other human beings, along with other computer systems, to achieve a certain purpose.
I think we need to be careful of the kind of ambiguity of AI. The way we talk about it is as if somehow you visit a website one day, you buy it, it arrives in the office, people unpack it, everyone knows what it means. Like, it's almost easier to think of it as a kind of philosophical viewpoint. It's more interesting to think of it as a kind of transformative change in our relationship with data and processing. And the more that we can think more in terms of customer behavior and customer expectations and the kind of meaning of this technology, and the more that we can use this as a toolkit to do better things, the better.
Along the lines of a philosophical approach, Marvin Minsky, we were chatting about earlier, thought of it as the second mind or the other mind theory. And essentially, around the age of two, these infants have these moments of realization where they realize, in many cases, their parents or the folks closest to them have other wants and needs and thoughts. And I think we as humanity are kind of having this awakening at this moment too, that there is this technology out there now that can really offer us this great ability to accelerate, amplify, augment our thinking in many ways. So I think, you know, when we frame it in that sense, the sky's the limit.
I do want to push back though. Coming from the technical side, these technologies are just math. So, you know, if we were to sort of use the technical jargon, we tend to talk about them as if they're other intelligences, and it's basically just some applied math. And there's huge ramifications for what that might mean in terms of our expectations on what's really possible and what's not. And yet the math and some of the breakthroughs over the past 5 years or so on the algorithmic side are really cool and astounding.
I think it's really important for us to think practically, right? We can think about theory of mind, we can think about all these things, but when it comes down to it, what's going to matter to an enterprise is what's practical, what's the practical outcomes of using AI, and how can we take this and really make a difference, make a company more customer-centric, make a company more efficient. If we're trying to build sort of an artificial version of ourselves, an artificial brain that can think about people and make really high-level decisions, how are you going to put that to work in the enterprise? We're very far from that. And how AI companies succeed and how companies succeed in deploying AI is find a really great focused use case. And always put business focus first. Always say, what do we need to do for our business? What do we need to do for our customers? And then try to see how can we go use AI to accomplish those goals.
The way AI is rolling into the enterprise now is through many narrow task-specific use cases. And so rather than it being the idea of the singularity that people like to talk about, it's really many very specific problems scaled out many times, and that's how it's finding its way into the enterprise in a useful manner today.
Especially when it comes to the enterprise, it's less about can we properly define AI and really what problems are we trying to solve.
What's happening, like what are the interesting use cases now in the enterprise? What are you seeing as some of the more interesting ways that enterprises are using and should be using AI?
I really see one of the sort of the gateway uses of AI being customer excellence throughout the organization, really understanding the customer, bringing those insights to bear in everything you do, from designing products to thinking through the customer lifecycle. And I think it's as companies and brands continually get used to the amount of data as customers reach out to them, being able to use that data throughout the ecosystem, we now have that power, and it can really transform things. It can really change your organization to somebody who's putting the customer first. And I think that that's really almost the gateway use case for AI.
And it goes back to what we talked about earlier too, is what exactly is the problem you're trying to solve and how do we put the consumer in the center of it all,
yeah.
Right? So think about something, we'll say as simple as financial planning, but the way, if you think about, we're living longer, much longer, we're working much longer, so all of the data sets that are coming in, they're so siloed, we need good system and good design to be able to pull all these together, not just tell us where we are today, but also help us predict what we don't know, what's going to happen in the future. I think it's where it's going to be very, very interesting.
And I think we all kind of unanimously agreed the highest order is the customer experience.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so
absolutely.
Coupled with now the technology is there, we've got access to these vast amounts of data, we can now create these experiences. And this notion of bringing human and machine together, not versus each other, but together, can really I think, accelerate that creation of those customer experiences.
And we have multiple.
Let's jump into the future, though, for a second, because I want to make sure that we have a chance to cap this off. So on the technology and innovation side, I think we had Catherine, we had Anand, we had Chris. You guys have some predictions for where this is going. Give us a couple of predictions that you would make over the next, say, 3 to 5 years.
I think one of the boldest one was by 2020, if a company is not utilizing AI in some way, they're going to inherently lose market value.
Yeah, the other thing is, I think the topic that we just brought up, the man plus machine would be much better than either one on their own. That's true in the enterprise world as well.